Let me know if you want that Aura nice yarn just in case the sweater turned out terrible. So I decided to use like a very cheap acrylic yarn. But now that I've done one and am more comfortable with customizing the size and fit, I am definitely going to make this pattern again, but in a more expensive, nicer yarn. My preference to wear is anything cotton. I prefer 100% cotton, but 100% cotton yarn is, in my opinion, very difficult to crochet because there's not a lot of give, and it's doable. You just really have to work with the yarn, and it's hard to crochet quickly. So I will most likely do a cotton and acrylic blend. But this one is 100% acrylic, which is okay. It's very easy to knit and crochet with. However, when I wear it, it's not itchy at all because acrylic is like polyester. It's kind of like that same material, so it is not itchy at all. However, I do notice that it doesn't like stabilize your temperature as well. And the only way I can describe that is I wore it into the office and I found that at points in the day I was getting really hot and it felt like the sweater was just like holding in a lot of heat. And maybe that's because of the friction with the acrylic. I'm not quite sure. If anyone knows why that is, please link down below. But so it is a comfortable sweater. I've worn it, but again, my preference is to go with the more natural fabric. Like, this is 100% cotton. So anyways, I am currently crocheting a sweater that is a different pattern, that's like a slightly more difficult pattern. So once I finish that, I'm sure I will show you all on this channel. But anyways, I just thought I would show you all, and again, I'm just so proud of myself, honestly. So along with crocheting, another favorite of mine that I wanted to show you is this beautiful yarn bowl. And it's exactly what it sounds like. It's a bowl that you put your yarn in, and that way you snake it out here, and that way when you're crocheting or knitting, your ball of yarn isn't like rolling all over the place. This was a Christmas gift. Was it Christmas or birthday? Something, one, either Christmas. It might have been birthday, actually. A birthday gift from Dali and Eva, my best friends. Because they knew I was getting into crocheting, and since then, they've actually gifted me another yarn, like, knitting-related gift, which I'm not... Anyways, they know that I've been really getting into it. And it's this beautiful bowl. It has these plant and flower details on the side. And it's like a very nice ceramic material. You can get these in any material, pretty much. You can get metal, wood, plastic, ceramic. So there's a lot of variety in what you can get, and you can honestly even just use a plain regular bowl, which is what I had been using for a long time. You basically just want something that the yarn can sit in so that it just doesn't roll all over the place. So I would say crocheting is a great crafting project or skill to get into, and it's very low cost. Like, really, you just need a ball of yarn, which you can get, you know, on sale or even secondhand for $1 to $5 for like a whole ball of yarn, which will enable you to make like a scarf or a hat. And you just need a crochet hook, which if you're just buying them in the singles, you know, it's maybe like $3 for a crochet hook. Or you can get a very basic set from Michaels that has all different sizes for like maybe $10, maybe $15. And there are hundreds and thousands of free patterns online for you to start learning how to crochet. You do not need to purchase patterns. The only time I ever purchase a pattern is when it's like a specific sweater. switching to knitting, and my goal is to knit a few sweaters. And please comment down below if you'd like a video of me talking all about crocheting and knitting and my own experience. But very basically, knitting is going to get you a sweater that lays much more nicely. So most of the sweaters you see in stores and stuff can be hand knit, and they're gonna lay nice and like smoothly, if that makes sense. Like this is probably like a knit sweater, and you can see it lays nicely. Whereas crochet, like let me just grab this little bunny ear. Crochet creates a much firmer texture, and it's a little more 3D, if that makes sense, than knitting. So knitting creates a much more fabric-like experience, whereas crocheting is a little more like textured and 3D'd. So it's honestly personal preference of what you like to wear and what you like to do. But I do want to try to knit a few sweaters, because you can just get them to lay a lot nicer, and that you can get them to be thinner, so you can make summer tops or like spring sweaters or cardigans that are just gonna feel different than crocheting. And so that is my next goal, is to do that. All right, next I'm going to pivot to some personal items. The first one is this cute little bag, which actually looks crocheted, which is hilarious because I could probably crochet this. But I actually got this bag at Goodwill for, I don't know, $6. And it's from the brand The Sack, which I think is actually a like a pretty nice brand. And this is kind of like a vintage version of the bag, because currently they don't have this same charm like the one that they have now. If you buy them online, it comes with like a different charm, so this makes me think this is probably a vintage model. But I just saw it and thought it looks so cute with the woven or crochet detail. It comes with a zipper, which I prefer. And this has been my everyday errand purse for a while, so usually I don't need to keep much in here. It's just my wallet and keys and maybe sunglasses. But this does have some storage, like internal organization, so it has some card slots, and it even has another zip pocket in the back. So for such a small bag, it actually has a decent amount of organization, which I like. And I also like that it's a shoulder length, so you can kind of see if I stand up. I really like this length. My other day bags are kind of all crossbody, or they have like a top handle, so I just wanted an option that went over the arms, like went over one arm like that. And this to me just like screams like 80s or 90s. And for me, I kind of like quirky bags like this. I don't really experiment a lot with my fashion, so bags are kind of an area that I will go maybe a little more out of my comfort zone. And I like to carry quirky bags. Not that this is like very quirky, but I do think it's unique, and it's like, to me, it's kind of quirky. I don't know. But yeah, it's this beautiful like woven texture. There is a full lining inside, so I can't really tell what it's like woven, like what the pattern is. But actually, you can crochet bags like this, so I wouldn't be surprised if at some point I crochet a little handbag or something. I might crochet one for my niece. Like, I think she'd like that. She's like 4 years old. So yeah, I've been loving this little bag, and great condition for only $6 at Goodwill. Next up is actually another bag. This is rare because, again, I do not really stop. However, this bag is not marketed as like a full-size backpack. I would say it's basically an in-between, a mini backpack and a full-size backpack. That's exactly what it is and why I got it. Now, I know Kipling has like a relatively large following, I think. I think it's pretty popular in South Korea and maybe Japan, but I know of it because of this signature nylon construction, which makes the bag really lightweight, which I like with bags like these that I plan on using when I'm traveling and stuff as like a day pack. I need something lightweight. My biggest pet peeve are bags that are heavy when they have nothing in them. Like I can't tell you how much I hate that, and I have maybe one bag in my collection that's like that. But all the other bags, I am very much a utility girly, so I don't mind that it's maybe it looks a little kid-like or ugly. That's fine. You can say that it's ugly. But for me, again, it's like form or function over form, right? Function over form. Lots of organization. It has two pockets in the front, two side slot pockets that, you know, could technically fit a small water bottle, but definitely not this one. That's okay. With day packs like this, I don't mind having my water bottle inside, and then I usually have one slot for my sunglasses and the other slot for my phone. Padded like a pillow, and so many different ways you can wear this. I will try to model them for you. The first one is like this, where it's low impact, basically. Like, it's very thin, so if you prefer to sleep like this, you can also double it up like this. My favorite for when I'm on a plane and I really need to, like, sleep with my neck up is actually to wear it like this, because this gives me the maximum amount of support. And usually on planes, when I'm just watching something, I just like to have this here, and it adds like a layer of warmth on the plane. One of my friends on Instagram, like, was posting about this just as her personal favorite, and I thought, ooh, that looks interesting, and I got it, and I have to say, it's one of the best travel pillows I've ever had. I've had, like, a nice luxury, memory foam pillow before. I've tried out the Turtle, which I was using for a few trips before I purchased this, and then I got this, and it's just been amazing. So much so that when my mom and dad came to visit me a few weeks ago, they actually took away my original one, and this is my repurchase, because they loved it so much. Just like seeing it here and trying it out here, they were like, we need to bring this back with us. So they stole mine, and I repurchased one. They're very affordable. I think this is like $30 on Amazon. I will link it down below. Absolutely love this, and it's great because you could even scrunch it up like this, you know, and sleep against the side of the plane. You know, good for car rides, train rides, whatever. I love it. Highly recommend. And they have a bunch of different colors, so I love this. And again, because it's so squishy and easy to like ball up, it's also easy to travel with. I usually just kind of fold it like this and have it either in my backpack or on the outside. There's like an outside pouch on my travel backpack that fits this perfectly. And again, it's just so soft. I don't know what the outside material is, but it's very soft. It's like probably a cotton and silk polyester blend. It's probably all synthetic, but it's, again, very smooth and comforting. And that's probably my number one travel essential, honestly, is that pillow. It's amazing. All right, next up is a personal hygiene item, and it is a water pick. Now, I don't actually use this one on a daily basis because it's not strong enough, but this is the water pick flosser, and this came in a 2-pack at Costco. So it comes with the home version, which is like a diesel one with a water tank and everything, and it comes with this travel one as well. And I obviously didn't want to bring my bulky at-home one because it's plugged into my bathroom vanity, but I wanted to suggest a water flosser. Again, I would not suggest something like this because this is not strong enough to be effective. You really need one of those units that's meant for the sink with a water tank. So just FYI, if you're purchasing, I will try to link one down below, but I got mine, like I said, at Costco. I absolutely love water flossers. I used to use one for years, and then for some reason I stopped. It's probably because our sink in our bathroom in our old apartment on the Upper East Side was way too small to fit something like that, so I ended up just giving it away. However, now that we're in a house again, I was like, I need to get a water flosser. And I really like them. Again, it is only effective if you are up to like 8 to 9, like level 8 to 10. There's usually 10 levels. All of the research and positive benefits that people see from water flossing are from those high levels. If you're flossing with like level 2 or 3, just feels so satisfying to like see all the gunk come out of your teeth, like at the end of the day, or even in the middle of the day. Like, I find myself, if I eat something that, you know, really gets up all up in my teeth, I will just quickly water floss, and it's like so satisfying to see everything that comes out and like feel clean. Like, flossing just never made my teeth feel as clean as a water pick, honestly. So I highly recommend a water pick. My dentist also says, you know, water pick or floss, either way is like effective. One is not necessarily better than the other. It's more so the difference comes down to like how well you utilize the tool. So, you know, you could be flossing and not flossing, right? And it wouldn't be effective. And again, same thing with a water pick. You could be using one, but not on a hard enough setting, and it's not going to be effective. So I don't think that, you know, one is a lot better than the other, but my personal preference has been the water pick all the way. So if you are thinking about doing it or something, I would just say work your way up. Start with like a 5 in the middle setting, and then work your way up to the strong setting. And I think you'll see differences. I personally really do feel a difference in cleanliness. And I didn't have any cavities in my last 2 checkups, so that was nice. But yeah, water pick. And I think the water pick brand, to my knowledge, is kind of like the tried and true brand. I usually like to go with like a name brand in this instance, just because they've probably done more research, even if it's, you know, paid for by them, at least they've done studies. Whereas like a knockoff Amazon brand, you know, they have not done studies on their product. So I would personally go with like a tried out, like a true brand. But I don't know, I, you know, I've only ever used water pick, so I can only speak for this brand. And yeah, I'll try to link the exact model of the you know, diesel one that I have. Gelatin. nice to know, you know, when you guys give me feedback of what you like or what you want, and I always try to take your suggestions to heart.